I'm Ian Hoffman, and I'm here to read you Jacob's School Play, starring He, She, and They. I wrote this book with my wife, Sarah Hoffman, and usually Sarah would be sitting here and I would be sitting next to her, but Sarah has a bad cold, so we put her to bed today. And so I'm gonna be reading by myself. Jacob's School Play is illustrated by Chris Case, who is a terrific illustrator and an all-around nice guy. And it's published by Magination Press, which is the children's book imprint of the American Psychological Association. So, let's read Jacob's School Play, starring He, She, and They. Jacob and Sophie were excited about the class play. Miss Reeves had helped each kid pick their part. Now, the classroom buzzed as everyone worked on costumes and sets. "I'm going to build the tractor engine," said Jacob. "And I'll get the wagon ready," said Sophie. "Emily, who are you in the play?" asked Jacob. "She's the cow," interrupted Noah. "See her tail?" Emily held up a string of pom-poms. Jacob looked at Noah. "You're the sheep, right?" "The ram," yelled Noah.
"Isn't a ram just a sheep?" asked Jacob.
"A ram's a boy sheep," said Emily. "See his horns?"
Across the table, Ari painted big blue swirls.
"Who are you in the play?" asked Jacob.
"Water," said Ari.
"Which water?" asked Jacob. "Are you the cloud, the rain, or the pond?"
"Yes," Ari nodded.
"I'm the water."
Jacob frowned.
"Ms. Reeves, why does Ari get to play three parts?"
"They don't have three, just one, the water," said Ms. Reeves.
Jacob looked at Sophie.
She shrugged.
Noah tested the glue, strapped on his horns, and ran headfirst into Ari.
"Stop it!" shouted Ari.
"What happened?" asked Ms. Reeves.
"He butted him," said Jacob.
"I'm not him," said Ari. "I'm they."
"Ari, you're just one kid," said Noah.
"They means two kids," said Jacob.
"They can mean one kid," said Ari.
Jacob dipped his brush into a tub of green paint and thought. Ari was water. The water in the play was three things. Was that why Ari was they, instead of he or she?
"Ari, are you a boy or a girl?" asked Jacob.
"There's more than just boy and girl," said Ari. Jacob switched to black paint as he worked on the tractor wheels.
"You could be a boy or a girl and still wear whatever you want."
"I do. Sophie does."
"So do I," nodded Ari,
adding ribbons to their cardboard cloud. Jacob painted and thought some more.
Ms. Reeves sat down next to Jacob. "Are you confused about Ari?"
Jacob nodded.
"Well, some kids feel like boys, some kids feel like girls, and some kids feel like both, or neither. In our classroom, we say he, she, or they when we talk about people."
"But boys can wear dresses," said Jacob, "and be he."
"That's right, but that's different," said Ms. Reeves. "This isn't about what you wear. This is about who you are, inside."
"Who is Ari inside?" asked Jacob.
"From the outside, we can't see who anybody is on the inside," said Ms. Reeves. "So we have to trust them when they tell us."
A week later, the classroom echoed with happy chatter as family and friends found seats for the play. Ms. Reeves turned out the lights and the room went quiet. She flipped the lights back on and the son stepped through the door.
"I'm up!"
Farmer Sophie stepped out of the barn and breathed in deep.
"I love the smell of sunshine," she said.
The whole room chuckled.
"Let's plant some corn."
Jacob rode the tractor out of the barn.
"I've got the corn kernels."
"Time to go in the dirt," said Sophie. She tapped each kernel, gently. Snug in the dirt, the kernels hummed a quiet underground song. Ari walked in and blocked the sun.
"Looks like rain," said Jacob.
"Good. Our farm needs water," said Sophie. Ari crossed the sky and rained down on the farm. The kernels rustled their new leaves and sang a bright growing song.
Ari traveled to the barn, where they filled the pond.
Moo, said Emily, walking out of the barn. I'm glad the pond is filled.
Bah, said Noah. Maybe you should take a bath. You're stinky.
You're a rude ram, said Emily, and chased Noah around the pond. Everyone in the audience laughed. Trailing raindrops, Ari stood up. Ari traveled back across the field, sprinkling rain on the corn again. The corn stretched and sang a happy, all-grown-up song.
Ready to harvest, said Sophie.
Jacob stood on stage and looked at his classmates. They looked so different wearing their costumes, playing their parts. But he still knew who they were. Suddenly, Jacob realized everyone was looking at him. It was her turn to speak, but he couldn't remember his line. So he said what he was thinking. Our class is just like a farm. We all help each other grow, and everyone grows up to be what they're supposed to be. Everybody, in their own way.
After Farmer Sophie had gathered up the corn, she joined Farmer Jacob and the rest of the cast in a line across the stage. They all held hands and bowed. The audience clapped and cheered.
Jacob whispered to Ms. Reeves, I'm glad Ari's there.
Why's that? She whispered back.
Jacob smiled. Because they know who they are.
Applause filled the room, and the kids bowed again. He, she, and they.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.